Hey guys, Idebytes Help here, welcome back to the channel, and Apple has made it official. Today Apple released iOS 14.6 to the general public, so everyone can now update their iPhones to the latest iOS 14.6, and of course, in this video we're going to go over some major features and some minor changes as well. Now, aside from iOS 14.6, Apple also released iPadOS 14.6, so you can go ahead and update your iPad as well. And WatchOS 7.5 is now available for Apple Watch users as well, with a few changes which we'll cover in this video as well. tvOS 14.6 was released today, and macOS 11.4 along all of those other software. So pretty much all of Apple platforms today have been updated to the latest 14.6, and there's quite a bit to talk about, as I mentioned. But before we get to some of the latest new features, let's take a look at some of the latest changes, starting, of course, with the bill number. The bill number is different here. Of course, it's going to be 18F72. Now, what's interesting is Apple last Friday released iOS 14.6 RC Two. So this software saw two RC candidates or release candidate, and today on Monday the 24th they released the official final release. Now, I did not film a video on RC2 because really Apple said there were minor bug fixes and security patches put in place for that one. That's why we saw a second RC, but this is the official final release and the build number is exactly the same as last Friday's release. So let's go over some of the latest changes. Now, on iPhone 12, some iPhone 12 users for different carriers are reporting new firmware numbers. So this one here was updated for me, 1.71.01. The latest firmware number has been updated. Of course, for those of you that have iPhone 12 and 5G, that could improve the network performance. I would like to hear from you if you did see a new firmware number or if you've seen improvements after updating on your 5G connection. So new bill number, of course, a new firmware number. There's also improvements to the app tracking feature, which was introduced with iOS 14.5. Apple has once again updated this feature. For those of you that continue to see this feature grayed out, Apple has addressed this once again. Hopefully, if you were seeing this feature grayed out, hopefully this will fix it for you. So Apple did note that that is something that they did work on once again. Now, there's new watch faces as well. So there's two new watch faces available. This one here, the Pride, right there it is, the rectangle and the circular one. And what's interesting is on the watch, you can actually spin these with the digital crown. So not only two watch faces are new, but you can actually move them just like so. As you can see right there, it looks pretty cool. So two new watch faces and the addition to be able to actually move these with the actual digital crown, which is super cool. So you have, as I mentioned, the square and the circular option, and they both can be manipulated and changed directly with the digital crown, which is something really, really cool. Now, there's also been some updates to Apple's privacy on the App Store. So that's also new here. Some app privacy updates details is available with a new splash screen as well. Apple also gave us a new splash screen here for the Apple TV app or Apple TV Plus application on the iPhone with Apple Originals. And right here it is, Apple TV channels. Pay for just the channels that you want and share them with up to 6 family members. So there it is. Not all features available in all regions, but yeah, a new splash screen is available there as well. Of course, this one brings support for the new podcasts and podcast subscriptions and podcast channels. So if you go to the podcast application on your iOS device, you'll now see those new features populate there as well. Now, there's some minor changes for Face ID devices as well. Right here, request attention for Face ID. So your iPhone will not lock unless you actually look at it. And that's been moved here. That was before under Face ID and passcode, but it's been relocated to accessibility, Face ID and attention. And that's where you find that toggle now as well. So a minor change there within the settings as well. There's also some new features within Apple Music. Apple has now tagged their albums with the new Apple Digital Master Copy. And of course, Apple is now bringing with AirPods the new spatial audio alongside Dolby Atmos, which I think most consumers will take advantage of this. There's also rumors that Apple is aiming to bring lossless audio as well to the HomePod and also the AirPods. So fingers crossed for that one. I haven't really notice any major difference in audio quality within the HomePods and the AirPods. I think that's going to be later with iOS 14.7. But yeah, as of right now, we have Apple Digital Master. Some albums are tagged as so. And also, we have the spatial audio with Dolby Atmos with 14.6. And if we head on over to settings, we now have under the cell streaming option, we have two options to stream audio, right? There are two different options. We have the high efficiency and we have the high quality options to choose from under cell streaming. So for your Apple Music is about to change big time with this new features. Hopefully, as I mentioned, AirPods and HomePods do get lossless audio in the near future, as is rumored with a new software update. We'll have to wait and see. Now, one of the biggest features coming to iOS 14.6 is Apple Card Family Sharing. So Apple is already sending emails, as you can see right there, Apple Card Family, and it says healthy finance family style. Now, anyone in your family group can actually share your same account, and this will actually help others improve their credit as well. So this is one of the biggest features. Apple is now allowing Apple Card to be shared across the family, and this is one of the big ones coming to the iPhone with 14.6. Now, Steve Moser, if you haven't followed him on Twitter just yet, he discovered that within iOS 14.6, there's new Beats products that he's uncovered. These animations that you see on your screen right now with three different colors, these reportedly are the Beats Studio Buds. Apple has yet to announce this product, but it looks like 14.6 and tvOS 14.6 will add support for these products. I'll link him in the description down below. He does an amazing job at doing some research within iOS. He's also mentioning that within settings here, if we go to exposure notification, as part of the exposure notification system on iOS 14.6, Apple is working to ask users if they have tested positive for COVID-19 in the results and they have been vaccinated or not. So Apple will soon most likely ask users that they've been vaccinated if they did report a positive to COVID, and you'll be able to enter those within the OS, maybe to create a card within the actual wallet of your iPhone to get some sort of certification that you are vaccinated, you were tested, and that you're doing good at the moment. So he's reporting on that as well. Now, there's also new support for the Shazam application within iOS 14.6. Their integration with Clips for the apps within iOS is now integrated within the OS itself. So that's something new here that Apple has added. As you know, Apple did purchase the Shazam application, which is now integrated within Siri. And now for the Clips, it's also available for the actual music detection system built into iOS. Now, there's also some updates to HomePod. If you have a HomePod here, as you can see, there's some new updates to the HomePods available. So right there, Apple has noted that 14.6 improves the HomePod experience. And I did update some of my HomePods to see the difference, and I've noticed that the transfer to HomePod feature has been improved recently with 14.6. The feedback that you get when you're close to a HomePod, and actually the connection has been improved as well. Apple notes that this software brings improvements and security patches. Overall, general improvements to HomePod together with 14.6 has improved the HomePod experience as well. So overall, 14.6 brings quite a bit of changes, new features, and improvements to the iPhone, to the iPad, as I mentioned. So go ahead and update to the latest version. Let me know what you think about this new software updates. I would like to hear from you in the comments down below. Stay tuned for my follow-up video, of course, where I talk about the battery and all that good stuff. But let me know if you updated. Have you seen any improvements, stability, anything else that you noticed within the software? I would like to hear from you. Thank you for watching this update, guys. Enjoy iOS 14.6, and I'll see you really soon. Peace.